the Globe Theatre, the Wooden O. Shakespeare's company of actors erected the storied Globe Theatre around 1598 in London's Bankside District. It was one of four major theatres in the area, along with the Swan, the Rose, and the Hope. By early 1599, the theatre was up and running, and for 14 years it thrived, presenting many of Shakespeare's greatest plays.
Hi, class. I'm here on the South Bank in London, standing in front of a replica of Shakespeare's Globe Theatre. Let's go inside and take a look.
In the exhibition area at the Globe, you can see this replica of the original Globe Theatre. You can see why, with its almost circular shape, it was called the Wooden O. Looking inside, you can see the stage area, the galleries, and the yard where the groundlings could stand and watch the play for a penny. And here, inside the theater, we can see the replica of the Globe come to life again. We can see the stage area, the galleries, and the yard, all under the thatched roof. The first thatched roof that's been allowed in the City of London since the Great Fire in 1666. The open-air octagonal amphitheater is three stories high, approximately 100 feet in diameter. The rectangular stage platform is about 43 feet wide and 28 feet deep. This stage, like Shakespeare's, houses a trap door in the flooring and rigging overhead for various stage effects, maybe for the appearance of Banquo's ghost in Macbeth. Right now, preparations are underway for a performance later today. I'm standing in the yard, where in Shakespeare's time, you could stand and watch the play for a penny. You were known as a groundling. Today, you can still stand in the yard and watch the play, but it cost a good deal more than a penny. If you were among the aristocracy or the wealthier middle class, you could afford a seat on one of these benches in the gallery. This replica of the Globe Theatre was built with authentic 16th century building methods, as you can see from the wooden pegs apparent in this beam. Today's Globe Theatre has no lighting system. Performances are during daylight hours, as they would have been in Shakespeare's time. The thatched roof does have a sprinkler system, and there are a few other concessions to modern safety standards, an attempt to avoid the fate of the original Globe Theatre. In 1613, during a performance of Shakespeare's Henry VIII, a stage cannon ignited the thatched roof and the theater burned to the ground. Although it was rebuilt, and Shakespeare may have acted there, he never wrote for it. It remained the home of his acting company until all theaters were closed by the Puritans. Now, as in Shakespeare's time, the flag flying over the theater indicates to the public that there will be a performance today.